Hello and welcome to the show. Now, following the joys of trying to autocross a Chevrolet El Camino, I thought for this week we would have a go with something a little bit different. Yes, it is the complete opposite end of the spectrum, a Porsche 914. It is a tiny classic roadster, and these kind of cars have tended to go pretty damn well. When it comes to autocross, let's face it, this is the sort of car that that you want. Light and agile, should hopefully be good at getting in between the gates. Although, having said that, there can at times be a little bit difficult to drive. They can be a little bit twitchy and potentially oversteery. We will have to see what this Porsche will do. Oopsie, not the button that I wanted to be pressing. From standard, it's £2,100. That's all, £2,200. That's not much. That's not much weight whatsoever. This will probably fit in the pickup bit of the El Camino. Almost, at least. So, yeah, we've got a lovely, tidy little car for this one. Tyres, they are only 245s on the back, and we're probably not going to have 235s on the front. They're certainly not the biggest of tyres. However, this is going to be pretty much a full handling build into A-Class. I think we will probably be okay. It might be a little bit oversteery, but I don't think we're going to have too much in the way of trouble with the Porsche. We will, of course, be running the Forza Aero, and I'm not quite sure what I'm doing about engine at this moment in time. So I'm going to start by going through here and putting on all of these bits and pieces, all of the handling parts first, and then we will worry about the engine. Well, those aero parts have added a fair amount of weight, but never mind. If we can get this car under £2,000, that would be pretty good. That would be pretty good going. We're not likely to perhaps get crazy levels of horsepower. Although that being said, we have had some very lightweight cars with 400 plus. They do tend to be a little bit on the interesting side to drive, but yeah, you can potentially get away with that much. But yeah, when that does tend to be the case, the car is an interesting oversteery thing to drive. We are indeed under £2,000, which is very nice indeed, and we're not even out of D-Class. Now, our choices of engine, what do we have to put in here? We have the 2.5 litre flat 4, we have got the 5.7 litre V8, or the 3-litre flat 6. Ooh, the choices. The choices indeed. V8 is always tempting. Always like to put V8s into cars. Plenty of torque and power from that one. They do all keep the car in A-Class, which is helpful. I'm kind of tempted by the flat 4 turbo, though. I have tended not to use this engine a huge amount, and it is the lightest. It's lighter than the car's standard engine. However, turbo lag is not ideal for autocross, but to be fair, we're not at quite low enough speeds for that to really ever be a problem in the previous turbo cars that I've built. So I think we're going to go with the lightest of the engines. We're going to go for the 2.5-litre flat 4 in this, and hopefully that will do the trick. We're going to go through all of the weight saving that we can. It's going to be plenty of power to weight ratio in this one. Going to be pretty impressive power to weight ratio, that is for sure. I will just quickly, I don't know what the gearbox is going to be like in this car from standard. It doesn't look like it's going to be too bad, to be fair. That loses us 3 PI, so I think that's the one I'm going to go for. It will probably give us slightly, apparently that reduces acceleration despite putting the 0 to 60 time up and the 0 to 100 time up. Well done, game. We're going for that. I tend to go for this stage because it often lowers PI, and these ones add so much PI for so little gain. And we tend not to have a problem with the gearboxes in the cars, so that is what we're going to stick with there. Gives me 20 PI left to play around with. Shall we have a look? We don't have any sort of weight-saving upgrades with here. Sometimes, certainly with the superchargers, the higher tiers will save some weight, but not with the turbos, not on this engine. Again, we're saving a little bit here and there, and not quite. We don't quite want to be going up into S-Class. bugger. We've probably got ourselves at that really awkward point. Yep, but everything is just one bloody PI too much. Okay, so we can get 5, 6, 7 there with one PI to spare, or we can get 5, 6, 4, and that's going to be too much. I'm not going to go for intercooler because that adds a huge amount of weight. So I think we're going to go for, not that one, we're going to go 5, 6, 7 on here, and then we will grab the driveline out of here, and that will have our car built. I will just check, see if I can sneak on the flywheel. You never know. Nope, can't in this case. We are at £1,815. It is very nice and light, with almost 370 horsepower, 350 torque. So, power to weight ratio is very, very good. Acceleration will likely be quick. It's all about how well the car handles. Of course, to test out the little Porsche, we have come to the Hockenheim circuit, where it will get 3 runs through the Autocross course. Now, this car may, just may, possibly challenge towards the top of the table. I'm not sure the Lamborghini Miura is quite going to be under threat. That 203.3 is still a ridiculously fast time, and I don't know whether this Porsche is going to have the grip to really compete with that Lamborghini. However, we could well see this thing challenging in the top 10, provided we have the handling. If we have a horribly oversteery car, if we have a bit of a twitchy vehicle and so on, we could be in trouble. I think it unlikely with this vehicle, but yeah, they are kind of the couple of things that I do slightly fear with this one. But nevertheless, we shall get underway and see how the Porsche will go. It's oversteery. Oh no, it is quite oversteery. We're going to have to be really careful, I think, with the throttle. Certainly, after the tyres have warmed up, it might be a bit better, but these early corners, we might have to be really careful, although it's very quick there. That was towards the 110 miles an hour mark on my first run through that corner. That is a lot of speed. In fact, that was very, very nice to be done through that section. It felt very quick, and it felt easy to carry that sort of speed. Front end very responsive. Bloody hell, don't go on the grass. That's going to cause all manner of issues. Right, so there's slightly terrifying moments are going on here. It does not have the rear end stability that I would like in a car particularly. I think, though, it might not quite be too bad. There is going to have to be a lot of, a lot of finesse. That's perhaps not quite the right word to describe it, but certainly an element of caution going on with the power delivery here, just to stop the rear wheels from spinning out of some of these slower corners, because that does cause some issues with this car. It's not so much at this higher speed stuff. We have seen some cars sliding through that change of direction. That's not an issue we have with the Porsches. Out of the slower corners, we don't really have the traction to put down all of the power. So that is definitely something to be wary of. Around the hairpin we go, and a little wheel spin on the way out again on the run up here with the camber changes going on. Now, it's not the first time we've seen cars get oversteery at that section, but it is all relatively manageable in this car. All right, now it is the final wiggle towards the line, and I've overcooked it ever so slightly on the way in. I'm trying to compensate. Yeah, I cocked it up big time through there. It is looking quick, though. That's with a 5-second time penalty and a very big mistake early on in the run. The Porsche is looking fast, if I can stop it going sideways. So, on to the second run with the 914. We have got to keep it out of the barrels. It was a silly mistake by me on that previous run. We can get away with a lot of speed through some of these gates, perhaps even to an extent that I'm not quite prepared for. I think we're going to have to try and be a little bit on the braver side with this car. It's one of these, it slightly terrifies me because of the lack of rear end grip, but that is so quick through that first section. That is just mega, mega fast, and then we come out of these bits and then suddenly all of the confidence evaporates because I can't put the power down in the way that I quite want to, and you've got to be very, very wary. Don't go on the grass, because that is a silly thing to do, and that will get you in trouble. It's nearly 80 miles an hour out of there with a little kick of oversteer from the Porsche. I had to have a lift because we were starting to understeer. It's still 120 miles an hour with a lift through that section. This is quick. This is seriously fast around here. I'm not that I'm surprised as such. After all, yeah, this is the kind of vehicle you want for autocross. Small, lightweight, and plenty of power. Decent power to weight ratio for the accelerating bits. It is, I'm liking it. That's 57 on the exit of that slow speed change of direction. That is the slowest gate on the track, and this car has probably been one of the fastest getting out of there. I can't say I've tracked every car at that section. It's one of those corners a little bit more difficult for me to look at the speed. They've got other things to worry about at that stage on the course, but that was a mega run out of that section. And now we have the don't spin the wheels up this part. We don't get sideways this time around, which is nice. Make sure we get it slowed down and turned in. Now we have that run towards the line with the Porsche. How much speed can I get out of the car down here? I don't think it's quite as dainty as the Renault. It isn't. As I try to get on that power, we get a big bit of oversteer, but it's gonna be quick. It's into the 203s. Oh, the Lamborghini is running scared. It's into the 203s with the Porsche there. Oh, if I hadn't got some oversteer, some wheel spin, oh, this is gonna be close. This is going to be bloody close. So it is time for the all-important question. Can the Porsche 914 find that half a second needed to go quicker than the Lamborghini Miura? It's going to be tough. That last run was pretty damn good. I think it is all going to come down to keeping control of the back of the Porsche. It is not as composed as the Miura, that much is for sure. While it is very quick, it's the slight lack of composure that worries me a little bit in this car. It gives you a slight lack of confidence at perhaps critical moments, and that's not something that you have a problem with in the Lamborghini, but the Porsche is phenomenally agile through some of these gates and has been carrying really very, very impressive speed. So maybe, just maybe, we can find the time, but we've really got to make sure I don't do anything stupid with the oversteer like that. That is the sort of thing that is gonna get the Porsche into trouble. Now get it slowed down for this next section, which we will do. It's just that the waiting to get on the throttle, I can't quite get to full throttle as soon as I would like to with this car, and I think that might be what causes its trouble in the end. But with these slower speed gates, it does. Now that's still good speed. I think it's quite as fast on the way out of there as we had last time around. But the change of direction is pretty damn incredible, considering that the lack of almost confidence I have in the back of this car is moving about as I'm trying to be braver. I'm trying to carry more speed through these corners on this run because, well, we need to try and make up half a second. And as I'm doing that, it's finding little bits of oversteer that I would really rather it didn't. Ah, come on, car. I don't think we're going to do it. I think we're down on the lap time slightly this time out. I'm going to give it everything I can through this last section. We have got on the power a little smoother. There's still a bit of wheel spin. It's not going to be quicker. 2044 from the Porsche. I tried. I threw everything at it. I think I might have been overdriving it a little bit on that run, and we just lost little fractions trying to get the time out of the Porsche. To be fair, having said that final run is still quicker than the Focus RS. The final run was still half a second faster than the Focus RS. It's just that lack of rear grip in this car. If it had the composure and gave me the confidence, this would be it is an incredible autocross vehicle as it is. It's just that the back end letting go at critical times when you're really trying to push it that is a little bit of a problem. kind of what I expected from this, you know, this kind of power in such a small car, such a light car and so on. You know, you expect it to slide around. I think the reason why the Miura has done so well in this series is it had giant tires. The car was a little bit bigger, but still very, very light and decent power. And you put that all together and you got a package that was easy to drive quickly. And while this is a quick car, it's not easy to drive it quickly. And yeah, it's just the little bits of time lost when trying to get on that power a bit sooner, where the Miura can do it, the Porsche just can't quite. It just likes to slither around across the road a little bit too much. It's not to the point, you know, where it's going to throw you in a wall and so on. It's not that bad. It's just it loses little bits of time, and those little bit of time add up over the course of this circuit. Still, though, to get into the 203s is a mighty, mighty fine achievement. The Porsche will go into second place on our leaderboard. Yes, it can't quite beat the Lamborghini Miura, but that is still one hell of a time going faster than, I mean, it's almost a second faster than the Focus RS, of course, beating the Renault 5 Turbo, the RS4, the 70s Corvette ZR1. It's a hell of a time, and it will, I believe, be the fastest car through that opening high-speed section, even beating the likes of the Miura and the Beetle. It just loses out with a bit too much sliding around, and it can't quite put its power down as well as we have seen from some other vehicles. But yeah, that is an impressively fast time. However, that is going to be it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.